This is my main bag, the Tamarack Expedition 8X. As you can see, it's fairly large and holds a good deal of equipment, which is why I decant things from it rather than carry the whole thing, as it weighs 3 stone, or 20 kilos fully loaded. As you can see on the side, there are 2 Tamarack accessory mounting points, to which I normally attach 2 lightweight light stands. The contents of this bag is effectively a portable 2-light studio. All I've got to do is pick it up and go, and I know that I've got everything that I need. Here you can see the 2 MAS side mounting points, and I'm going to attach the water bottle to one of them just to show you how the Velcro on poppers work. The other side is a mirror of this one. Obviously here I'm not going to mess around with the poppers, I'm just going to Velcro this into position and pop the bottle in. Something I'd carry instead of the light stands if I was on a hike. On the back face of the bag is the tripod mounting. A large pocket at the bottom takes 2 of the tripod feet, and 2 straps further up go around the tripod to hold it in. This is finished at the top by another large strap that holds the whole tripod securely into the bag and ensures it doesn't start rocking around. These straps naturally have a degree of adjustment in them, and when it's secure, I'm pretty confident that my tripod is going nowhere. 2 side accessory sections are ideal for holding the little bits and pieces like memory cards, batteries, all the fiddly stuff. Inside each section are 4 pouches and 4 tabbed enclosures. The tabs are supposed to tell you which memory cards are empty and which are full, but when you've got several SD cards in each pocket, the system doesn't work. Each black pouch can hold 4 AA batteries easily, but the tabbed sections are much thinner. Designed for compact flash cards, I typically have 4 SD cards in each section. Oh, and the zips are pain to close. Behind this is a laptop storage area. Personally, I wouldn't store an actual laptop in here, as I'll explain later, but I store all sorts of other things, like a portable reflector, 4 lighting umbrellas, 2 reflective, and 2 shoot-through, and some laminated paperwork that has records of key moments in the ongoing oppression of photography by the police. I've even laminated to them so that they last longer. I even have the PACE paperwork, so if someone starts giving me aggro along the lines of prevention of terrorism, I can read them chapter and verse. As I'm more likely to have this bag with me in unfamiliar territory, I should have all the facts I need to educate an ego-driven officer. Coming around to the back of the pack, you can see the large amount of padding that is included in this particular model, and that it really is designed to do some serious all-day carrying. The shoulder straps are also well padded, and the waist strap is padded to the side of the hips. Once done up, you can see the straps give plenty of room for adjustment. Something that I'll also do is have a lens case on the forward waist straps, so that I've got a lens change ready to hand should I need it. There is also more adjustment on the shoulder sections as well, making this backpack quite flexible in terms of size and comfort. As well as a small adjustment on the top, a larger section exists further down for more alteration. There are also 2 smaller attachment points on the shoulders for more equipment. Before I open the pack up, you'll notice this weather flap. It's designed to cover the zip and has a drawstring to help prevent water getting inside the main section. Pull it tight, and it gives another level of protection from the elements. The main body of this case consists of 2 parts, the usual segmented area and 3 wide see-through pockets. We'll take a look at the pockets first, as these are the reason that I won't store a laptop in this bag. Open the zips and you can keep other things in here. I have wireless triggers, cabling, sensor cleaning kit, and even my sun compass. If you have anything bulky in here, it could put pressure on a laptop, and I won't take the chance of breaking something like that. The segmented area contains the usual culprits, and in my case comes with more than enough Velcro dividers. It's configurable for 2 bodies in the center if you so wish. In here I have not only the camera and lenses, but 2 flash units, hot shoes, filters, light stand brackets, snoots, grids, and basic color gels. It really is a 2-light studio. On top of that, it even has a portable battery charger in it for the camera that I can use in the car cigarette lighter. The trick is, with this, is that if I'm on a holiday, I'll take the lighting equipment out before going on a day hike. This actually makes it a very comfortable and practical backpack. If I want to, I can store food and compact waterproofs in the freed up lens slots, so the one bag really can carry it all on a day hike. As equipment comes and goes, the bag itself has a degree of change about it. I've even stored long lenses horizontally, using the Velcro sections sideways to create a cradle. On the one hand, getting a backpack of this size seems like madness, but it really does give me a lot of options. I'm 5'8", and you can see that this isn't small. The tripod adds even more to this bulk. If you're going to put things on the side attachments, be aware that you might not be able to reach them without taking it off your back, so a walking partner will really prove helpful. This is also a reason why I keep a lens pouch on the front of the waist, easy to reach without having to stop to get at things. It's also worth noting that extras, such as the water bottle and the external pouches, will cost more money and don't usually come with the backpack itself. At the front you can see two plastic D-ring attachment points and the smaller receivers for extra pouches if you buy them. The chest and waist straps fit snugly and you can better see the chest adjustment. At the side of the waist even the side attachment point is a bit far back on the hip, which makes it awkward to use, but generally the whole thing fits well, is comfortable and easy to use for a day hike. The other thing I'll warn you of is the rain cover. Another extra cost, it only fits the backpack if there isn't a tripod attached. If you've got a tripod on, the rain cover won't fit, so if you plan on carrying a tripod often, the rain cover could be a waste of money. On a hike, the camera's normally in my hands, and one of the lenses on the waist strap, so this takes even more weight out of the backpack, but I leave the camera space free in case it rains. The backpack's reasonably easy for a single person to get on and off, but I'd plan how you lay things out, as putting it on and off all the time could be a drag during a day's walking. Other lenses and equipment that I don't normally keep in the backpack, but I need to have ready for transport, sit in this older shoulder case. Lots of Velcro sections make it flexible, so as equipment comes and goes, I can change how it's configured. If you've been shooting for a number of years, you've probably already got an older bag like this that you can use. It has plenty of separate pouches for various bits and pieces of cabling, and I mainly use it to store backup equipment, so if something goes wrong during a shoot, I've got more options. At the top, the filter holders store, well, not much to be honest, and the old film canister holders are now used for batteries. I even sew them to the lid to stop them coming off the Velcro. At the back is a long storage pouch that I never did find much use for, but more importantly are two loops that are great for storing a monopod, or pretty much anything that's long but not too wide. They can't easily store something like a tripod. The long story short is that if you're finding your main bag is too small, but you don't want to buy a larger one, then keep a lookout for an old bag like this going second hand. It can take some of the storage pressure off you. In the last part, we're going to look at storing the supplemental equipment, like extra lighting gear, larger brollies, and things like that.